golden ticket! I waited so many years for it, it's finally coming true!
I know, buddy. Hey,
don't
wait, relax, dude. It's okay.
Star Wars!
Star Wars!
Holy freaking lordy, it is actually finally fucking here. After 32 years of dying to see what was going to happen after Return of the Jedi, Star Wars Episode 7, The Force Awakens, has finally arrived.
What year is it?
What?
What year is it?
2015?
It sure as hell doesn't feel like that with all the movies coming out, right?
Yeah.
Really?
Just think, for 2015, we have gone all the way this year, giving us sequels for Jurassic Park, Avengers, Terminator, Hunger Games, and now Star Wars.
Honestly, I don't...
Cannot wait!
Yeah, none of us can wait.
None of us can wait! The wait is finally over!
Yeah. Seriously, I think I've been staying up long hours on end waiting for this. On the way here, I was listening to fucking Star Wars music in my car. I really don't give a shit.
It's crazy to think that the very news that we were getting a new Star Wars movie dates back all the way to when we were all still in high school. And after all this time of theories and speculations and rumors jumping back and forth on what's going on their part, the day's finally here. Holy fuck.
The surprising thing was it's not called Star Wars Episode 7. It's just called Star Wars The Force Awakens.
They're not even calling it Episode 7?
No,
yeah,
no.
Yeah, they are. Wait, tickets says Episode 7.
Well, our tickets say Episode 7. I don't know. So I don't know. Tickets can be weird like that.
The crawl credits are probably going to say Star Wars Episode 7.
Yeah, I guarantee they will be. Regardless, it's of course the 7th fucking movie.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Unless you count the Clone Wars movie, then it's the 8th.
Yeah.
Or if you also count the Ewok movies.
There was an Ewok movie?
Yeah, can you believe
that? But those
are
made for TV, so.
Well, I mean, there's also the Star Wars Holiday Special, but we don't talk about that.
Oh, God.
Yeah, it's the 7th movie.
Yeah. So, hey, guys, real quick, we just want to say Mark is going to the movies with us. He's just not here in the car right now because he's still at work, and he's not going to get off until a few hours from now, so he's going to meet us at the theater, and he will be around for part two. So,
yes, sir.
Blame him.
Fuck you.
So, what are y'all excited for? If not everything and anything.
Everything and anything.
And anything.
Star Wars.
It's just Star Wars. Exactly.
Dude, regardless of it being Star Wars, the number one thing I think I'm most excited for is our characters are back. Sure, we got new characters, but...
But at least they don't, like, throw the old characters, like, under the rug.
Fuck no, man. We got them all. We got Han, Chewie, R2, 3PO, Leia, and we have Luke, right?
The first trailer.
Yeah, seriously, where the hell is Luke?
He hasn't been in a single trailer. We heard him monologuing.
Was he in the first one?
We heard him monologuing.
No, Joe, all this time, you and I have sort of thought that one clip from the...
From the first trailer.
From the first theatrical trailer, you know, when you see that character, that hooded character with R2 putting his hand on him.
Yeah, it's a robotic arm.
Yeah, that was definitely a robot arm, so we thought that was Luke this whole time.
Turns out it wasn't?
Well, I have no idea. Maybe it wasn't.
It has to be.
From what I've heard...
I would imagine.
Well, from what I've heard, it's like that's supposed to keep you guessing.
Yeah, like
it's
maybe either, that's supposed to like, that was throw you off guard.
Yeah, that was Abrams' intention with that. It's like, is that Luke or? And now that we haven't seen him throughout any of the little trailers, it's kind of like, was that Luke?
Did Darth Vader rise from the dead or some shit?
No,
dude, if that's the case,
holy shit!
First of all, we see his skull.
Second, we see his helmet
with a skull.
His mask.
Wasn't he in incinerated in 6?
Yeah, but, Luke cremated him.
Yeah.
I guess his mask and skull survived the cremation.
But it lives!
Okay, guys, so, yeah, this is fucking Star Wars, so it's honestly gonna be our biggest film reels yet, and we can go all over the place. We can go in so many different directions. We can give you guys our thoughts and point of views of the original trilogy, of the spin-offs, of the prequel trilogy, and everything else, but honestly, that's kinda gonna take a while, so we thought we'd just keep it a little simple today and stick to what we're excited for with this movie. So right off the bat, what do you guys think is gonna happen of the old characters, of Luke, Han, and Chewie, and everybody?
I think Harrison Ford is finally going to get his wish and have Han Solo be killed off.
No, it can't happen. No, it cannot happen. You can't kill Han.
In Episode 5, he wanted his character be killed off.
What, he would have, died within the carburation?
Well, yeah.
Yeah, they had sense to rewrite it because you can't kill off Han Solo. You just can't. That's like killing off Indiana Jones. Can't happen. So, after seeing the trailer and everything, what do you guys think is going to happen with Han and Chewie?
Ooh, I don't know.
I'm hoping that Chewie is a little gray.
I know, right? Looking at the trailers, how clean and, non-aged does Chewbacca look?
Maybe Wookiee's age...
Yeah, who knows? Maybe Wookiees sort of age like a Yoda species. It takes them years.
Well, yeah, it does.
It doesn't even look like him at all.
Yeah. Chewbacca's, his race does take many years to, like, show, like, actual age. Well, they wrote it like that so he could appear in the prequels.
Of course.
What do you think is going to happen to Carrie Fisher, or Princess Leia?
She better stay alive.
I think she's just going to be, like, commanding some troops.
That's what I sort of think, yeah.
Be, like, the general.
Yeah, again, yeah. Also, guys, we sort of want to point out that it's Star Wars, you know, so all the fans are going crazy with their fan theories, putting them all over Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, and everything else. We haven't really been paying attention to any of those. We strictly go by our own theories and what we think is going to happen. I think these two new characters, you know, the new chick and the new dude who's going to, Finn, I believe his name is.
Yeah. I'm still trying to get that down.
I don't even know the chick's name. So what I think is going to happen is these two characters are going to meet, and then they're eventually going to meet up with Han and Chewie, who I guess are going to be, you know, kicking back a little bit on Tatooine or something like that, still cruising around in the Falcon, and they're sort of gonna, like, tell them what's going on, you know, because it looks like shit's about to get real. It honestly does. Like, even though the Emperor is dead, Darth Vader's dead,
and someone wanted to bring him back alive,
and the galaxy is supposed to be free, it looks like a new threat is gonna arise with this new villain.
Kylo Ren.
Yes. I'm always forgetting his name.
Yeah.
He looks cool, though.
He looks amazing. I love his lightsaber.
Yeah, his lightsaber kicks ass. You know what? Instead of the whole thing, you know how everyone's going crazy with the lightsaber right now and the fact that it has the prongs on the side?
Yeah,
the hilt. I honestly don't care about those. What I think is cool about his lightsaber is how the blade, it looks much more fiery, you know? It's a lot more jumpy and jittery.
Yeah, also
like flames. Yeah, also, that's what I think is awesome. So what do you guys think is going to go on with the new characters? Again, judging by the trailers and everything else, because that's all we've been paying attention to, what do you think is going to happen with Finn and the new chick?
The Finn guy's obviously going to take on Kylo Ren and probably beat him.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, but
new Jedis!
Here's my thoughts. I think Finn might be a stormtrooper.
Yeah, from the trailer, it looks like Finn is going to start off as a stormtrooper, but he's going to be like the only stormtrooper in the galaxy that actually has a sense of morality. So he's going to want to try to join the light side and join Han and Chewie and hopefully Leia and Luke, wherever the hell he is.
Or maybe he's just doing the whole thing that Luke did in episode 4.
Yeah,
maybe,
that could be it.
Maybe. It might just be a disguise. I would like it better if he was a stormtrooper.
Yeah.
Yeah, that would be pretty cool.
That would be pretty cool to watch.
Yeah, throughout the trilogy, try to name one stormtrooper's full name. I dare you. Exactly.
Sir Finley Merkleton?
Whatever.
Jerk off!
So, guys, in all honesty, what do you think is going to happen with the new threat? Like, rather, if it's the Empire coming back for a rebound, you know, the Empire Strikes Back Part 2 or something like that. It only took them 30 years. What do you think the new evil plan is going to be with this new Sith villain?
Beats the living heck out of me. I have no idea.
I'm pretty sure it's going to be the same shit as Darth Vader.
If you guys
finish what you started.
Exactly. The fact that he said that in the trailer. Now, because he said that in the trailer, and from what we've seen with a couple of posters, I kind of hope this doesn't go in the direction, but in the back of my head, I sort of have a feeling that they're going to try to make a third Death Star. I just have a feeling.
I'd be okay with it.
In a way, I'm okay with it, but in a way, I'm not okay with it, because it's like, oh my god, guys, this would have been the third time. Well, how big is the exhaust port going to be now? And the second Death Star, you could fly your fucking ship in that exhaust port and shoot, so now how big is it going to be? It's big enough for another Death Star to fit in there.
Or probably a whole fleet. Well, I mean, if they screwed up the first two times, I'd say they'd listen after that.
Yeah, right? I think Robot Chicken said that best.
I'm sorry, I thought my Dark Lord of the Sith could protect a small thermal exhaust port that's only 2 meters wide.
So, hey, one theory we want to talk about that we've had for a long time. Now, we're sure other fans have kind of thought this too.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Yeah.
Again, we don't pay attention to anybody else. But honestly, right off the bat, from everything that we saw with the original trailers and everything else, there was a time where we were sort of starting to think that maybe Luke, and the fact that we haven't seen him yet, we were starting to think that maybe Luke is the new Sith, if he is Kylo Ren.
I mean, it makes sense.
It's insane, but it's not impossible. Maybe after 30 years of what happened with everything, you know, Darth Vader and the Emperor and everything else, maybe there's still little traces of the dark side still wearing down on his mind. So after 30 years, who knows? Maybe something would have snapped and he winds up crossing over.
Remember the end of the fifth movie? Remember when he was listening to Darth Vader and he was telling him all this mumbo-jumbo dark side propaganda? And he...
It is your destiny, yeah.
There is a lot of evidence supporting that theory.
That's what made us think. And even the other stuff in the trailer, you know, in the trailers, we barely see Luke. You hear Kylo Ren say that one quote, "I will finish what you started." Maybe he is talking directly to his father, you know, his father's disembodied head.
Or he's just really one hell of a fanboy.
Yeah. Maybe he is one hell of a fanboy who just happened to find where Luke left his remains. Now, is there any particular monsters or creatures or whatever that you guys kind of hope will make sort of a rebound for this new movie or these new movies that are going to follow?
So, I want to see more Wookiees, damn it.
More Wookiees, yes, please. The third movie has Wookiees, but we want more.
Well, I want to see...
I've always wanted to see Chewie's family.
They are also so funny.
You do see it in the holiday special.
No, right. Does not count.
Personally, I like to see some of the races from the prequels.
Yeah, hell yeah.
Like, making an appearance.
We still don't know what the name of Yoda's race is. We have no clue.
I think they're called Yodas.
No.
Speaking of Yoda, I hope we see Yoda, Obi-Wan, and Anakin's ghost.
Yes, their ghosts need to make an appearance, please. Yeah, it's gotta happen.
I really hope that, like, when you see Luke, like, he's still able to, like, talk to them.
Exactly. But if it goes that route, you know, Obi-Wan and Yoda will be there, but so will Anakin. And who's to say that Anakin will still be played by Hayden Christensen if they do that? That doesn't bother me. I know a lot of people bash his performance, but I honestly don't mind so much. I don't think it's great, but I just don't mind.
Well, here's the thing. It might not be the best performance, but all the whininess and stuff
is legit.
And it was also intentional.
Exactly.
Because that's how Luke acts.
Yeah. That's part of the hero's journey. That's, you know, the trait has to be doubtful of what he's going through and what he has to accomplish.
And like I just said, like, throughout the original trilogy, Luke is, whines a lot.
Of course.
But I was going into Tosche Station to pick up some power converters.
Power converters! Of all the movies, my favorite creatures, I think, are from Return of the Jedi. Like, I hope we see, like, a whole planet of Rancors or something like that. And also, I'm just gonna honestly say, I wouldn't mind seeing the Ewoks again. I actually love the Ewoks. Sure, they're goofy and kind of cutesy for Star Wars, but I think they're awesome. I mean, think about it. The Ewoks was the single greatest opportunity in Hollywood for little people since The Wizard of Oz. Or Willy Wonka. Or hell, maybe even the first Star Wars. I don't know, you guys decide.
One thing, speaking of the Rancor, one race I would like to see from the same Jabba the Hutt scene would be that blue elephant face.
Yeah, that little blue elephant dude, and also...
I would like to see a shit ton of those people.
Yeah, that, and also Jabba's little pet, you know, the little ear guy.
I like to see...
That guy.
I thought that was the weirdest thing ever.
Hey, wait. One thing I would like to see is that blue elephant guy, somebody from that race, wielding a lightsaber.
Oh my god.
A blue lightsaber.
We're gonna wrap it up here with one more question I have for you guys. Now, I've already asked this a couple of times, but in all honesty, guys, where the hell is Luke? Where do you think Luke is all this time? We can only assume what's going on with Leia, Han, and Chewie, but what about Luke? What do you guys honestly think?
Only one way to find out.
Yeah.
Again, I hope it doesn't resort to the twist that Luke is the new Sith. I hope it doesn't go that route.
You know what? Personally, if it does, I won't be too mad. That's a good plot twist.
I won't be too mad. I'll just be shocked if it goes that direction.
What a twist!
One more thing that I'm expecting or would like to happen is Boba Fett make a reappearance.
Yes!
I like them to be like on Tatooine. They go to the Starlak pit and
he crawls his way out.
And he crawls his. He somehow blasts his way out of there.
Back from the dead, assholes!
Exactly. Because
then he gets the lightsabers and shit.
Because there's talks of like an origin story for him, so it wouldn't make too much sense for him to still just end there.
Yeah.
Also, when he climbs out, they should stick to how the comics had it and have him falling two more times.
Yeah, why not?
Yeah, because that's the most pitiful character there. He dies.
He got pitiful.
Get off the stage.
Pitiful, you asshole.
The fact that it took you a minute.
Yeah, it took me a second.
Speaking about pitfalls, I like to play some Pitfall.
Sure. All right, guys. After 32 years of waiting, we're finally going to see what's going to become of some of the most beloved characters in all of Hollywood.
So when we come back. And so, hopefully it's better than the prequels.
it's probably going to be better than the prequels.
Yeah.
We can only hope. I mean, they learned from their mistakes, so you can only go in good directions from here on out, I hope. So yeah, in moments we're about to see what the 32-year-long wait is all gonna be building up to as soon as we get to that theater.
Aren't we there already?
Aren't we there?
We're here.
We're here!
Star Wars! This is the price we get for showing up 3 hours earlier.
This poor bastard here is still out of it.
Wake up!
What? What about you? What are you doing the past time?
Listening to Star Wars music.
Figures.
I've been listening to Star Wars music pretty much all day.
Nice.
I was listening to the ending theme and this and the opening theme.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure he's going to wind up puking after with all the Star Wars stuff by the time he gets home.
Please, you kidding me? Star Wars is my life.
Star Wars is life.
What about you, Nick? How are you passing the time?
Not bad, just on Facebook. Look me up.
Stay off Facebook. That's crazy, man. There's going to be spoilers. Stay off Facebook.
I don't care. I don't read the spoilers, so you guys are good. We're good here.
All right. Our show time is at 7:50, and we have just about an hour beforehand.
Starting it?
No.
It's starting it?
No.
It's starting it?
No.
So, as you can see, we're still just trying to kick back here and wait for the magic.
No.
Is it starting yet?
No.
Is it starting yet?
No!
Yeah, it's nuts.
Star Wars. I said, I'm done with it. No, what's up?
And he's done with the movie.
Want it?
No. Two more minutes till showtime.
Just remember, there will be spoilers next part, so if you haven't seen the movie, we apologize.
Hold it!